The wish to replace software developers with AI is real. Industry leaders all over the place talking about how we can actually automate simple tasks in software development. And that's the key to understand. So we will talk about who or what will be replaced in the next years to come, and how we as software developers can adapt and change in order to stay on top of the game. Is AI actually a friend or a foe? Let's find out. So executives and large companies want to replace us. No, actually, they don't want to replace us as human beings. The intent is to automate this simpler task, the actual hands-on task, the things we call programming, the things we call coding. And the bad thing is, those are the things we actually like to do, right? So I'm a geeky person. I do in programming things. 32 years now, started on Commodore and Amiga to do things in BASIC. And I love that. I love it today. So even though I'm a CTO in position, I'm still coding and I love it because it is a great thing to do. And now everyone is coming in and try to replace that away from us. So is it the case that we don't do that nice stuff in 3 years anymore? No, it's actually not. When we compare that to other industries out there, like the car industry or something like that, then we would need to assume that at least 20% of the developers will vanish because just AI can do the job, right? But there is something very special. When we take a look at the car industry, in 1960, we had 7 million cars built by 1.6 million people. And today, it's 11 million cars built by 900,000 people. So there is actually a high demand and less people working in the industry. So that's not good for the jobs. But how is it with software industry? In year 2000, in the US alone, we had 500,000 people working in the software industry. And today we have 1.5 million people working in the industry. Why is that? It is simply the demand. The software industry space, the IT space, is actually powering all the other sectors in the market. This is called digitization. That means that the IT is pushing other sectors. So there will be probably always demand for that because it's intertwined in all the other sectors out there. And that is very important for us software developers to understand. That means that there is enough space for us to find a job and for us to keep our roles, but we will need to change.
And if we can use and leverage AI correctly, then the current developers will be more effective. And that's the actual goal of the AWS cloud boss. He said, it was actually a leak, but he said that AWS won, and this is many CTOs want to have that CEOs, that software developers focus more on the clients and the business outcome than actually on doing coding. Because coding is actually quite worthless. It is the same with infrastructure. No
but
one
makes I enjoy it.
Yeah, exactly. I am enjoying that as well. But it is not what makes the money.
And that is why
we will see more low-code solutions in the future. And no matter who software developers say today, no, that's nonsense, that will not happen, look at the output. Yeah, look today at the output, look in 10 years at the output, look in 20 years at the output. If you look at the output in 10 years.
Great background.
Not even sure that in 10 years, in a decade from now, we even look at output anymore. And let's get into why we need to change. There is this little thing called Devin. And some months ago, Devin was causing turmoil because it was the first digital software engineer, so our direct replacement. It turned out to be no replacement whatsoever. It couldn't simply replace the person who's connecting all the dots, the business domain, the requirements, who's talking with other developers, who was talking with other product owners about how to create a good solution for the problems out there. This is what humans need to do. You need to have intuition. You need to have emotions. You need to know if what you create will probably be a good thing or not. This is where the actual demand in the future is. Only good quality software will survive long term because there's so much on the market. So quality really matters, not the quantity anymore. So that means that we as software developers need to focus on that and not so much anymore on coding. That hurts a little bit because I actually love coding, but that's the reality. Does that mean that we as software developers don't code anymore? Probably not in the next years. So in the next years, we will talk more about things like code completion or generate me some function or something like that. these kind of things. So we decide what we want to have coded, and AI is actually doing that for us or doing suggestions. We pick that, refine that, and take that. So we are still the pilot while we have a co-pilot. So that is actually the relationship between us and the machine. It is not pair programming. Some people say it's pair programming. It's not pair programming. It is simply our calculator if you would try to do math task. It is basically the tool which makes it possible that we can focus on the bigger picture and don't need to focus too much on the nitty-gritty little problems. And that leads us to another problem. We have juniors out there who are just starting these things, and we have seniors out there. So what I just said is quite easy to execute for experienced and seasoned seniors who know exactly what they want to see, right? They expect something, they can prompt it correctly, they know it, they can even fix it or even throw it away or write it themselves. But what is with the junior developers? So to keep it short, junior developers should focus on the fundamentals first before they actually dive into the AI story too deeply. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to have a video about that, because I had this topic so often already on other channels. That is actually a quite interesting topic, how to start as a junior developer with AI or not with AI, or what you actually need to take care of there. But let's switch quickly to the idea of where will the hands-on part be substituted. It is most likely the case that large enterprises, Meng, Feng, enterprises in general, will be the first who start to replace those simple tasks by the AI machine. And that's natural because they have the resources, they have the foresight, they have the people to doing that, they have the money to do that. And smaller companies do have another problem. The software developer in a smaller company is actually higher in demand than in larger companies, which means that the software developer in a smaller company often needs to do multiple things in a company, which makes this person more intertwined in the processes than the developer in large company might be. Which means that even though the software developer in a small company can leverage AI to make those things more quickly and more efficient, it is harder to replace this person in general. In small to medium-sized companies, the replacement will probably happen in several years to come, but not right now. If you are extremely afraid, try to take a look for small to medium-sized company. They might have a better opportunity for you there than the larger companies. If you are totally into AI, it might make sense to take a look for larger companies because they are totally aware of that and they are totally keen to do something about that.
I found mine a point which is a positive one for developers. I wondered, as a CTO went before, I wondered what's the right amount of developers you should have. I also wrote a blog post a long time ago about this. Because I look at the companies and I see companies doing great things with 10 people. I see companies doing good things with 100. I see companies doing bad things with 10,000. I never understood how the amount of developers is related in any way to the problem to solve. And I think the amount of developers is just a percentage of revenue or from investment, whatever you have, either revenue or you have investment. And then they just, people spend 20% on developers, and that's the amount of developers you have. And then you have revenue, margin, costs, and then some percentage of the developers. So with this model, if this model is true and the companies have the money, they would keep the same amount of developers than just doing more. We now only spend 5% on development in the future instead of 20%, that because of AI. But I also have the hunch that the amount of developers is still determined by revenue. That's the amount we want to spend on development. AI is not in that equation.
So let's get to the good parts, to the value part. So what is AI currently doing for us, and why should we as software developers adapt? So we have two types of tools we use right now. The one is the code completion part, like GitHub Copilot, and the other is some form of generative text-based thing, which often does have some access to your code base, not very deep right now, but some access in some form, at least the files you have open. And with those two tools, most developers right now work. You have several implementations and several IDEs, several plugins where you can leverage those tools. Are they good? They became quite good for me. They were bad in the beginning, but they tend to learn together with me. They learn from outside. And today they're actually quite useful. And I can say that AI is helping a lot to increase efficiency. And what I mean by that is actually getting rid of the tedious tasks. So I am not keen to write the 50,000th version of a specific loop or an algorithm anymore myself. That is not the fascinating part of coding for me personally. What I want to do is actually to solve a problem. I have talked to a client, I talked to a user, I talked to a stakeholder, and now I want to find a solution. And I want to focus on that solution. I want to get it right. I want to see the big picture. I want to see the code base itself, the architecture. I want to see those kind of things, but not really if this function now is a for loop or a while loop and it's just a simple thing just on the side, right? Since things like Copilot learn together with you what you actually want to have and what is the tendency to see, it will be actually quite accurate in completing what you're writing right now. And this simply saves mental capacity. You can focus on other things. We are humans. We have problems with our focus. And that's what it's all about. And the other types of AI actually help you in the bigger picture to create something, maybe to create entire functions or get some information how you can optimize a part of the code just to have some second thoughts about what you're actually doing right now, some suggestions you might not see because you already have coded for 6 hours and you're becoming quite tired. And very often those things really help you to stay effective. And I don't see that this kind of technology is substituting me as a person. How can it be? It is simply impossible to do all the communications to actually understand the emotions behind the changes we make. Yes, because for example, in the front end area, you do those things and you know that it must be something that other people like. And how can you determine that as an AI? You don't. You know in that moment that this kind of implementation isn't fluent enough. It won't be fun to use it. You will see that as developer, the AI isn't seeing that. So those little things are right now impossible to be doing by AI, and it will be for many years to come. So see the AI as what it is. It is your tool, your helper, your co-pilot, while you are the pilot. So that's the conclusion right now. The demand is growing on the market. And with the demand growing on the market, you will have more developers on the market and you will compete against more developers on the market. So you need to stay up to date and you need to be able to deliver and to be as efficient as you can be. So use to learn AI in order that you become more efficient doing real developer work and focusing on what matters out there, which makes you more interesting for small and large companies at the same time. So that is the whole idea behind the big change right now. No one wants to just replace people. Everything needs to be more efficient. So you need to become more efficient as well. I hope that was helpful for you. Let me know what you think about AI in the comments, and I wish you a great day and a great week. Goodbye, everyone.